How's it going, everyone? Nikash here. Welcome back to Gankstars Academy. And today, I'll be showing you guys how to change your res and the best in-game settings for you guys to use. So the next section of this video is the settings section. Now, the settings is the most personal, like preferential thing in the game. You know, settings vary for every single person. Every single person's settings aren't the same because one person's, for example, mine, my settings wouldn't be, you know, the preferred settings for you. So I use a Final Mouse Air 58 Ninja, which is a 58 gram mouse, which is extremely light. So my mouse flies, and I play on 800 DPI with a 13.131 sense on my X and my Y. And this sense is actually medium. It's not too high or too low. It's just in the middle. And I can vary between using my wrist and my arm for aiming and tracking and that kind of thing. So my targeting sensitivity, this is your ADS sensitivity for when you scope down, or not when you scope down, when you aim down the sight of your weapon. And for me, this is 8.847, which I think is perfect. And my scope sensitivity for when you're sniping or using a scoped AR or a scoped revolver is 0.595. Now, these are my settings, and I think these are some really good settings in my personal opinion, and they fit me really well. And if you guys, you know, want to change something up, feel free to, because settings, you want to mess around with them until you can get down on one which you really, really like. So, now we're going to go to the resolution aspects. So first, let's go over the different settings that we have here. So we have view distance. If your PC can handle it, you always want to keep this to epic. This basically lets you see players from a good distance, and you can just call them out, get some shots off, maybe hit some, and it's really beneficial in the game. Next is shadows, and you want these off. Shadows kind of basically are just there to give you a better looking performance, but they also take up a lot of GPU use, and they just make you run a little bit less frames, which, you know, you want more, the most amount of frames that you can have possible. Next is anti-aliasing. This makes everything look smoother, especially the edges of something in Fortnite, and this also takes up FPS, so I have this setting turned off. Now, textures are very useful because it helps you see through, you know, certain structures and something like that, and you can see an enemy through a certain structure pretty easy. It also helps you see enemies a little bit further away from you because it kind of blends them out, so they're easy to spot out, and it's pretty easy if you want to fight them and take their loot. So I definitely keep that setting on. I keep effects and post-processing low. Effects is just, you know, more kind of like, if you guys remember back when Kevin the Cube was in the game in season 6, you would have remembered that he had a storm around him, like a little tornado storm on the island, and you would just see little specks of dust and everything on the screen, which I personally don't like seeing because it's kind of distracting and hard to see through. But you know, some people use them, like Ninja, for example. He uses effects, but I prefer to keep these on low. And post-processing, to be honest with you guys, I think it just basically does the same thing as shadows, anti-aliasing, and effects. Just makes the game look nicer visually. And I am not really into that. I'm more of into how many frames can I get, because that is pretty dope. Now, you want to keep VSync off, because VSync doesn't really, what's it called, affect your game if you have it off or on, even though it says it takes away screen tearing. But it really doesn't, you really don't need VSync, because it's kind of useless if you have a good PC. And even if you have a bad PC, you want to keep this off, because it does in fact lower your frames. So motion blur, this is just a personal preference. If you want to have motion blur in your game, if you want to move around and see some sort of blur, or if you want to move around and see, you know, just clearly like how it normally would look. And I want show FPS on so I can see how many frames I'm getting in the game. Now, what you want to do is you always want to play in full screen mode. This is definitely important for getting a lot of frames, and it makes the game feel smoother as well. And to adjust your frame limit, this is the button right here. So 240 to unlimited, to 30 to 60 to 120 to 144 to 165 to 180 and 200. You know, these are all your frames or whatever you want. However much frames you want to, you know, get in the game. So it's all personal preference. Now we have display res. So right now I am on native, but I play stress resolution, and there's, you know, a different way to do stress resolution for everybody. You can use 1444 or 1440. I personally use 1280 by 1080 because I think it's the best res for me. But you know, everyone has a different preference. Same thing with res. You know, if you want to use something that's not too stretched, go with 1440. If you want to use something that's not too native and more stressed, go with something like 1154 or 1280. And some people even use 1079 by 1080, which is crazy, which I don't even know how they managed to use that. But, you know, it's all personal preference. And if you guys don't already know, stretched res does provide an advantage in Fortnite, as the vertical aspects of the game are more vertical. You can see more vertically. However, the horizontal resolution is the same, so you get to see the same amount horizontally. But vertically, it does give you an advantage in build fights, which is why I personally use a higher amount of stretch res, so I can have more, what is the word? Awareness in build fights. But that is basically the settings, guys. You know, we have volume settings. This is all personal preference. If you want to have high volume or low volume, if you prefer music on or off, colorblind mode. You know, if you have some sort of colorblind issue with how you perceive colors, so you can, you know, switch your colors up to whatever, which one you want. But I don't have any colorblind issues, so I just use the normal one. We have your keybinds, which this is all personal preference as well. You know, it's pretty easy to get used to normal keybinds. Once you set them up at first, it's pretty easy to use them. And then you have your gamepad settings if you use a controller on PC. And finally, you have your account information and that kind of stuff. So that doesn't really matter, but just mainly the resolution and your settings here. And I play on one brightness because I play in the dark a lot. So yeah, but that's basically settings, guys. So now I'm gonna show you guys actually how to get a stretch resolution. All right, guys, so finally I'm going to be showing you guys how to change your Fortnite in-game resolution. A lot of pros use this and some casual players do as well, and I believe that there's a big advantage because of the vertical field of view that it gives you. So I use stretched personally, but it's all personal preference if you want to use native or stretched, but I just prefer stretched. So what you want to do is you want to make sure you are completely closed out of Fortnite and the Epic Games launcher, so you don't want any of that open. And right now, the first thing we want to do is go to the game files, and the way to do that is to search up %localappdata%, and it's going to pop up this little folder right here. What you want to do is then look for Fortnite game. You want to click on that, click on save, click on config, Windows client, and then you'll see game user settings, this file right here. Now, the first thing you want to do is you want to click on it and right click, and you want to hit properties, and then you want to hit read only and make sure it's unchecked. Hit apply, and then open the file. And as you can see here, we have all of our game settings. So what you want to do is you want to find the resolution settings, which is down sort of towards the middle. So as you can see, what you want to change right here is resolution X, resolution Y, if you want to change your Y resolution, but I prefer to keep it at 1080. And then you also want to change your last confirmed user resolution, depending on if you want to do the second one as well. And you want to change the desired screen width and the last user confirmed desired screen width. And so mine are already at 1440, so I'm currently on stretched. But yours will say 1920 if you don't play stretched. So then you just got to change the numbers, and you want to hit the X, and then you want to go back to game user settings, hit properties, read only, and hit apply. The next thing you want to do is you want to right click on your desktop, and I have an NVIDIA control panel because I have a GTX 1080 Ti graphics card, weird flex, but I want to hit this button right here to open up the control panel. And this takes a little bit to load up, so just don't worry. And I don't know how to do it if you have an AMD. I'm sure there's a lot of tutorials out there to do it on AMD, but most people that I know have NVIDIA cards. So as you guys can see, I'm very variant with what resolution I'm using in Fortnite because I'm just trying to try everything out. So sometimes it's not gonna pop up, but to change your resolution, what you have to do is you wanna first go to adjust desktop size and position. So when you do this, you wanna make sure you click on the monitor that you're using. So XG2402 series, that's my 144Hz monitor. So what I wanna do is set the scaling to full screen so that you don't have black bars when using stretch resolution, and you wanna perform the scaling on the GPU. And you wanna make sure to override the scaling mode set by games and programs. And this stuff doesn't matter, although your refresh rate does matter, because make sure it's on whatever cap your monitor is on. So the next thing you wanna do is hit apply. This will take a little bit, so you're gonna get a black screen, whatnot. So there we go, everything's all set and applied. The next thing you wanna do is you wanna hit change resolution, and what you want to do is you're not going to have any of these custom resolution sets. So to create a custom resolution, say you would like to use 1440, you hit customize, and then you don't see it. You know it's already here and we see it. I'm just going to act like I don't see it from your perspective. So you're going to hit create custom resolution, and then it's going to pop up this box right here, and this is where you change whatever res you want. So say you want to do 1440, you put 1440 by 1080, keep it at 144 because that's my cap frames on my monitor, and the color depth doesn't matter, but you want this to be progressive. And then just hit test, and since it already exists for me, you know, I can't test it obviously, but for you it will not. So then your screen will go black and then it will be okay. And then what you want to do is you want to make sure you want to X out of everything except for this last window right here, and this is where you want to do a very important thing, which nothing will be saved unless you check the box. So right here it's unchecked because I just unchecked it. You want to check the box and you want to press OK, and then you're gonna be good. And now all you got to do is just open up Fortnite and your game should be in stretch. So let's go ahead and check that out real quick. As you can see, my mouse, this is my PC desktop, and it finally rendered, and now I'm currently playing on stretched resolution. So that's awesome, and basically that's how you do it. That's really all it is, guys, to stretched resolution. It's a pretty simple thing. It definitely does improve your gameplay, and yeah, so that's about gonna wrap it up for this tutorial, guys. If you did enjoy it, make sure you guys drop a like and sub for more Gankstar Academy videos. And if you guys want to go ahead and check me out on stream, I'd really appreciate it. My Twitch is going to be in the description as well as my supporter creator code. But that's all it is for me, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope it helped you out. And I'll see you later. Peace.